Looky, look what we got here. All right, we got to use Chrome, but that's no big D. Wait, that says 14. Hold on. You guys aren't seeing an up-to-date picture here. How about that? We're not getting any sound now. Oh, shit. Oh, that's why. There we go.
Hey everyone, this is Aaron Greenberg from Team Xbox. I'm excited to be coming to you here live from my
kitchen. There we go.
I'm drinking nonstop
drinks. You guys good?
Out of the world's fastest, most powerful fridge. We're moments away from a huge Inside Xbox. First, I want to let you know, a lot of people have been wondering what
are we doing. Yeah, you guys aren't seeing anything at all.
We're not taking the summer off. We're working hard. Teams cannot wait to deliver new games, new reveals, new news for you.
Why is this thing not working right?
To get hyped. You're going to see today the first ever Xbox Series X gameplay from our partners around the world. Damon Baker and Sarah Bond, who lead our partnership team, have brought some of the best developers and creative teams to the table. They're going to be joined by Jeff, Katarina, and Malik. Team Xbox coming in strong. It's an exciting day. We know fans have been waiting for this, but also we know you're wondering what's going on with Xbox.
There we go. Sorry about that. I got it.
Teams now around
the world. I got it.
You blew us away at XO19. You blew us away at the Game Awards with Hellblade 2. We know you've got more.
Let's change the title, too.
With that, I want to welcome the head of Xbox Game Studios, Matt Booty.
I'd like to change the sound as well, because it's not coming out of my speakers.
I want to start by saying that our first concern is really with the safety of our teams and, of course, their families. And that's why they are all working from home right now, whether it's in Sweden,
that COVID's got everybody killed, man,
or the U.S. And I've really been impressed with the ingenuity and the creativity that they've shown to get around some of the challenges that we're
hang tight, I got it.
Moving forward on our great lineup of games. So, we're excited that we will begin unveiling gameplay from our studios.
There you go, I got you.
In July.
I got you guys.
Including some from our newer studios.
How's that?
Like Double Fine, Ninja
Theory. Yeah, everyone's going to get the COVID, right?
Whoa, Matt, it feels like we might.
Are you guys finding the audio? Are you guys okay with it?
Aaron, also.
Not too late, not too quiet, not too loud.
That's right. It's time to get hyped. Halo's coming. Halo Infinite, you've been waiting. The world's most anticipated game, July.
Yeah, the audio is whack because his audio is whack. It's not me. It's his audio. His audio is fucked up.
Big reveals for you.
It sounds that way because his stuff is shitty.
I can tell you we're going to work every week between now and then to deliver for our fans. But today, we're going to put the spotlight on our partners and let them shine and show you what Xbox Series X gameplay looked like. Let's have a go.
I'm hoping for the God damn it. It did it again. You guys keep losing. Okay, hang on. Hold up. Properties. Look at that. Hopefully it will stop doing that. I don't know why it keeps doing it. Titanfall? Is that a new Titanfall? What the fuck? Man, it would be cool if that was a Titanfall, but I don't think it is. I don't see any robots. This looks like Haze. The new Haze? Dark Souls with guns? Everything Dark Souls with guns. Another first person shooter? I already got COG, man. I don't want to do that. I have already got COG. Special events. There we go. Mal, what the fuck? Now we got a car? Is this RoboCop the game? This shit is super bizarre, man. Bright Memory Infinite. Marvel Infinite? All right, whatever.
What you just witnessed was Bright Memory Infinite from Playism, created from the ground up by a single individual at FYQD Studio in China. Developers are using the hardware to achieve their dreams.
Hey, if it's done in China, does that mean it's going to have spyware?
Using the power to optimize their games the way they want.
You guys see this shit? That's what we're here for.
Frame rates,
ray tracing, Assassin's Creed vanilla gameplay.
Yes, faster in-game load times. But it's also
awesome
to see
the
partner support
for
smart delivery, ensuring that fans only have to purchase the game once to enjoy it on whichever Xbox system they own or will own in the future. So, over the next 25 minutes, we're going to debut just a slice of the amazing next-gen games you can expect from our partners this holiday and early next year.
Yeah, I came for AC.
And because we read the interwebs, everything you see here will highlight the in-game experience, with actual gameplay captured in-engine to give you the best sense of what to expect when Xbox Series X launches later this year.
So if you are they saying if you buy an Xbox
and enjoy the following dreams being
you get an
Xbox
sex game version for free? Is that what he's saying? You get buy the not sex and then you'll get the sex? If like maybe you upgrade later or something? Sure. Sure, smiley face. Why not? Is this more Forza? You know, every time a console comes out, they have to have some kind of a racing game, right? Ridge Racer. Everybody's gotta have a Ridge Racer. I'm not, like, super stoked on how this... I'm not super stoked on how this game looks. Uh-oh. Sorry. I fucked up again. I got you. It's like, whenever I touch the window, it fucks things up. Sorry, I won't touch it. I know you're missing out on gameplay. This doesn't look any better than any current game, right? Oh, it's Dirt 5. Okay, well, big surprise. Exclusive? What happened to that Dirt game Eris was playing? Is this Elden Ring? Xbox Game Pass. Dirt Rally, that's what it was. Alright, I kinda like this. This looks kinda cool. I sorta like this. Damn, it's poop. Wouldn't it just poop out? Death Stranding 2? Ooh. Hey, this is kinda trippy. It's got a weird penis that's ejaculating. Into a womb. Is this aliens? This is definitely aliens. That is sexual, and this is the Xbox Sex. This is Aliens Xbox Sex Edition. I don't know. What the fuck is going on? This is really weird. They said this would be gameplay, man. What the hell? Is this gameplay? This is really overt for aliens. Ooh. This is not gameplay footage. They said everything would be gameplay footage. Hey, did I just go out and get lied to by Microsoft? Did I just get lied to by Microsoft? I'm pretty sure I did. Kazuya?
Together, we built order. out of chaos.
Scorn? Yeah, I don't know what that was.
Each trial, each tribulation, we have overcome. Now we live in an age of unprecedented peace. We have prevailed.
Damn, thanks Starship to game? Her.
Let her ascension serve as proof of our righteousness. It is in her honor that we strive for chorus.
I'm not really getting a vibe here, you know what I mean? Scorn was kickstarted in 2017 and still not out, and that's a fucking Xbox.
This ends with us.
Xbox sex, that's what they're gonna show, it's a kickstarted game. This looks kinda lame too. It's like a fucking, I don't even know, it's another shooter. It's just like another, it's a space shooter. I guess. Star Fox. It's Star Fox, but grimy. Grimy Star Fox. Yeah, so far, oh, hey, of course,
what's up, everybody? Thanks for letting me crash
this
the show.
This is the kind of Patrick guy you gotta be to buy an Xbox. If you dress like Kansas this guy Chiefs. And you're looking at his cock right now, fucking buy an Xbox. If you see his hat like that, buy a fucking together. Xbox.
But hey, I'm here.
If you can see your own crotch with the shorts like that, buy a fucking Xbox.
Xbox Series X.
I'm sorry, but that's what it is.
I can't wait to get my hands on it. It's been a journey that's older than me. And I was lucky enough to be a part of it this year. Like they say,
I just call it as I see it, man. I'm not fucking
about to go.
I just call it as I see it. Whale biologist. I call whale biologist. Call it as I see it. This is kind of cool, but this isn't what they're selling. Every inch, you're the... Every inch! Every inch, all right. Woo! Every inch.
Brady gonna try and throw on third down.
Good job, you're back. Man, I wish I had a beer or something. Fuck. I have a beer, but I can't go get it because we're watching shit. Ooh. Hey, it looks good. It looks good, I'll give it that. This is what I'm talking about. I'm excited about things
There's
looking a little better.
Oh
my god, someone cover up this guy's crotch, please!
It's about what you can see, it's about what you know.
Oh, Jesus!
But here's the best news. When you buy Madden NFL 21 on Xbox One, you get it free on Xbox Series X.
This is distracting! This guy's Johnson is flopping.
Honestly, I'm ready to just get back on the field. Enjoy the rest of the show, and get ready to
fill
next level.
Why would you sit that way in front of a camera? Oh, God, he makes me want to fucking play Madden so bad.
Huge thanks to EA for giving us that sneak peek at Madden 21 optimized.
I'd sit that way?
Series X. That was awesome. So, my name is Sarah Bond.
Oh,
and
Jesus. Why can't she sit that way in front of the camera?
Which means I get
because she doesn't have a fucking salami that can flop
out. Developers and creators around the globe that are creating games on, with, and for Microsoft platforms. I just love my job because it's all about connecting creators and publishers with our fans.
I like how they keep saying this. This is literally the only thing people are here for. Not the titties, but the message before the titties.
Right now, games that are going to define the generation.
They're just like, please stick around for the Valhalla.
And I am thrilled to
share. We need the vanilla, man.
Every major publisher worldwide is developing for Xbox. And we already have hundreds of games coming to Xbox Series X.
So nothing, have they actually shown an exclusive yet? Because like,
tremendous, guys.
That Kickstarter game can't
be. I've never seen partners as excited about Xbox and Xbox
Capcom?
Series X
oh,
as
boy.
They are right now. So
you think Street Fighter V's multi-console?
More of the great games that they have been working on.
Street Fighter 6? If it's Street Fighter 6 multi-console, that would be all right. I think that's fine. I want to know more about this smart delivery in the rear. What is with all this creepy shit, man? This already looks horrible, right? But at least they're showing games, but they haven't shown any gameplay yet. They showed one gameplay. Two gameplay and three trailers, right? Four trailers? Is this like Heavy Rain? This doesn't look any better than the PlayStation 4. This looks like current gen. This doesn't look like next gen.
Let's show them how we do. Everyone grab a lid.
Bye-bye now.
Well, there's a little bit of gameplay-ish. What the hell am I supposed to get excited over here? This is like some Bioshock Infinite shit. At least there's a little bit of gameplay. Spider-Man? Superman? What's going on? This looks horrible! This looks horrible! Look at the face! That guy's face is fucked up, man! Vampires? It's a pretty uncanny valley. That at least looked a little better. The face of... Oh, Vampire the Masquerade. That exact... Okay, that would be that. Okay. That would explain all the dumb shit. That explains everything. Well, is that an actual exclusive? I don't think it is. I think it's just world premieres. I don't think these are exclusives. They said it was going to be exclusives, man. No, it's on Steam. Well...
Oh, Harry.
Is that really exclusive? It's a console exclusive. I think that's what they want to say. Oh, God.
I've traveled so very far to find you. How strange that your trail ends here.
Ori in the Blind Forest?
Very island of my dreams.
Oh, my God. That does not look good. Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
When you left, mm-mm. I was withering away.
Listen, Forest Walk and Talks. I know. Walk and chat, but let's here, not even pretend that the Sony isn't going to be doing the exact same stuff, okay? Let's not even go there. This is literally the shit Sony's going to show too, so fucking don't even fucking focus on that. That's not Xbox, that's just modern gaming today.
Whispers of things long
Sony's going to be just as bad.
Will we be forgotten too? What did you find here, Harry?
I don't see anything super amazing. I was kind of interested in that Scorn, but you told me it was kickstarted like, you know, 3-4 years ago. That's the only thing that's really caught my interest so far. Maybe that fucking Masquerade, but I don't know. I don't think
so. The Ascent Group main metropolis.
Like damn, you, nice mech.
Most people have
hold
contracted
up
their entire lives away to get here.
They might have got
workers
me now.
Indents, slaves in all but name.
I like this. I'm liking this so far. This has got, I like this setting. It's got me interested.
If the latter is true, the corporate craft teams will already be moving in. This is a crisis supernova. The Ascent Group has collapsed. We have a shot at true independence.
Cyberpunk? It might be.
Let it go to waste.
Nope, they lost me. I don't like it. It's trash. It's garbage. I'm not interested. They duped me. They fucking duped me. This is not representative of what they just showed in the trailer. I'm not even interested. No. Get all out of here. I don't care. Diablo? Fucking Diablo? You have this. They have so far never gained my attention as much, and then dropped it as hard as they just did with this. Yeah. No, fuck it. I'm not down. I haven't been down. I'll never be down. I don't like that. That's not a fun gameplay. That doesn't look like anything I'd be really interested in at all. Fuck. Jeez, what is with these games and fucking? Ugh. This really is the Xbox sex. This is the Xbox sex. How many games now have fucking had chicks in their wombs? Well, show me a good fucking game and I'll like it. Fucking Christ, man. Fucking yelling at me because I'm calling an orange an orange? Fucking, you love oranges. You better love oranges. Fuck you. These kids are good as AF. Ugh, can you even call some of them a game though? Is this gonna be a game? This looks like Assassin's Creed. It's Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Death Stranding 2, Xbox Edition. Once again, no gameplay. Once again, no gameplay. But at least the last one had gameplay, it just disappointed me.
Hi.
Hi.
Hope you enjoyed the reveal of The Medium, our
really?
Next-gen psychological horror game. We're very excited to announce that we're working
this
on the project
for
in cooperation
a plan
with Akira Yamaoka, the legendary
team?
Composer
that,
best known
right?
for the Silent
team?
Hill series. Jeez. We'll have more to reveal soon. So stay tuned.
Yeah, stay tuned. We're gonna watch more of this indie game. I'm down. Look, man. We can at least we'll have Steam, right? This will all be on Steam, so we can at least have it there. Or whatever Xbox service they have, right? Xbox will have a service. They'll fucking do it. I'm not gonna get hype. Oh, Bandai Namco? Okay, hold on. No, I'm not gonna get hype. Forget it. Not hype. A little hype. No, I'm not hype. Forget it. Yeah, I'm not hyped. This is some more Dark Souls, anime Dark Souls, isn't it? Yeah, it's more anime Dark Souls. Everything wants to fuck on the Xbox X. They're all seductively posed. Not Tekken 8. No, this is Tekken 8. This is Tekken Tag Team. Damn. Rear penetrate. Damn, the hard rock.
Ready?
It's Devil May Cry again, but... anime? Isn't this like that one Switch game that everybody kinda liked? Oh my god. It's got the Japanese butt rock and everything. Wild. Code Vein? Yeah. Well, this is not Code Vein. It's that one game where like you had a pet robot or something. I don't know. It was for the Switch. You were like a police one. Yeah, the police one. That's right, that's right. Looks like that. Just another one of those. I mean, it was good though. People liked it, so. Alright. Scarlet Nexus. Okay, Astral Chain. Thank you, yeah. Look, this actually, I'm not gonna shit on this game. This one looks like it could be an Astral Chain, and I think Astral Chain was actually pretty good. I think people liked it. I think that's something people might be okay with. And Bandai Namco, they kind of know what they're doing, right? So that's cool. All right, one somewhat reasonable game that I would never fucking play. Yeah, nowhere near new game graphics, not even close. But so far, this is all they do with the graphics, right? First-person shooters. Oh, shit. Was that a dinosaur? Kinda. Okay, I like that. Dinosaurs, rally your squad, because you have to play multiplayer games now. That's all it is. Alright. a lot of the same dinosaurs. I'm starting to lose some hype a little bit, but you know what? I'm getting some Turok vibes. I like that. A lot of bloom, a lot of explosions, a lot of blur. Giant T-Rex. Okay. Game and console in development. Yeah. That actually did not look very good. I tried really hard to hype it up. I'm sorry, Turbo. I couldn't do it. Hey, they're gonna get Yakuza on the Xbox X. Which one is this, though? This is not the latest one. We played that. This is some other version. Family room. This still looks exactly like last generation's Yakuza. Ah, this is the new one. This is the RPG, right? This is the role-playing game, Yakuza. Damn, this one's like way crazier. The lobster? This was like way crazier than the last Yakuza. They're just going fucking all out now, man. Like a dragon? Oh my god. This is some... It's an RPG though, right? There's no way.
That's
definitely an RPG,
right? シリーズの最新作であるヤクザライクアドラゴンを
I like that. It might actually be an actual normal one.
そして
Xbox One and Windows 10
で発売する運びとなりました。全世界のファンはもちろんですね。
No, it's a normal one. Look at that.
このタイトルを手にする方にも楽しんでいただきたいなというふうに考えております。ゲームの限界に挑戦する龍が如くスタジオの新たな挑戦を
pushing the limits and it looks exactly the same.
というふうに考え
ております。It looks exactly the same as the last one.
ヤクザライクアドラゴンをぜひよろしくお願いします。
You know, I might buy that on Steam. I might buy that on Steam. I don't like. I don't think I would want to buy it. Is the problem?
Series X. This is just the beginning.
I would rent it if it comes for PS4 or PS5. I'd rent it.
But until then, I'm just going to have to live out that fantasy via custom backgrounds in Microsoft Teams. How about I try out a few now?
Shush.
Maybe
I don't know who this guy is, but he's
Scarlet
talking.
Nexus, or maybe I could tear up the streets in Dirt 5, or well, here's a
are we,
quick
this
view
guy is literally
Bill
ripped,
Spencer's
right? Showing off his green screen.
Wait a second. We've got this inside look at the next Assassin's Creed game. So with that, I'm going to leave you with the gameplay debut of the highly anticipated Assassin's Creed Valhalla for Xbox Series X. Huge thanks to all of our partners for their hard work during these difficult times, and to you at home for joining us. Stay tuned to go behind the scenes with a few of the creators of today's lineup and hear more about their thoughts on the next generation of games.
You don't really want to be here for that.
See you later this summer for even more content premieres and announcements from Xbox Game Studios and our partners worldwide. Thanks so much.
All right, just whatever. We shat all over Xbox. Let's get some Valhalla in here. Assassin's Creed Vanilla, here we go. Checked out that guy's sick-ass green screen. Now we're gonna check some sick-ass Assassin's Creed Vanilla. This doesn't look like gameplay so far. I think I'm being bamboozled right now. Still waiting for the gameplay. Come on, man. I want to see some... I'll take a cut down black flag all day. This music is horrible. Where's the fucking gameplay? Is that gameplay? Was that gameplay? That better not have been it. Man, I'm starting to get pissed. This ain't funny. You better show some fucking game.
Few titles demand the respect and fandom that the Assassin's Creed series has garnered, and today we get to talk about Assassin's Creed Valhalla with its creative
get
director,
this fucking guy Ashraf off my Ismail, TV right now.
Who's joining us from Montreal, Canada. Bienvenue to Inside Xbox.
Hey, Jeff. Pleasure to be here.
I'm so glad that you're here because I'm a huge fan of the series. After seeing the video
gameplay
that we just saw, I have
I can't stand this. Get this fucking
guy. Before we get into Valhalla itself, did I just see new Assassin's Creed gameplay for the first time?
Yeah, absolutely.
Did what gameplay?
From the game, in all its Viking Age glory.
Let's talk about the Viking Age because Assassin's Creed Odyssey, Assassin's Creed Origins, these took place in
this guy literally just said, did I see some gameplay? Did he literally just fucking shit in my mouth and say it was gameplay? Here's a fucking gameplay for you. Fucking shit.
The Viking Age, it's named after...
Did he just call that gameplay?
Notorious warrior cultures.
You tell me.
And this time period...
Chat, you're the all wise chat. You tell me. Did we just see gameplay?
By this very large... Hungry,
I could have sworn that was
and
not
at the time, England
actually
was
playing a
dark
game.
Age
that is,
angle of
that is so
broken
bullshit.
Warring kingdoms.
That is bullshit.
So this was
in
an
motion.
Absolutely brutal, pivotal moment in history that gave us
I'm
the birth
more,
of the England we know today.
I am more upset
so
now than I have ever
can
been.
Expect to fully live the Viking fantasy in a meticulously crafted journey in an Assassin's Creed.
I'm not
world.
Believing anything this guy
right,
says.
So let's get
or
a little
guy.
Bit more into this. There was a lot to take in that clip that we saw. I saw Viking longships. I saw some
it's a cutscene from the
game,
so gameplay.
Previously
I fucking
want to
leave. I want to so actually get off my couch and leave the room, but fuck it, I made a commitment to you dorkos.
Yeah, so
I gotta sit right here and talk
Eivor
shit about this game that I was looking forward to.
Who's going to leave the snowy mountains of Norway for the lush rolling hills of England, propelled by the goal of settling their people and growing a
so
thriving
upset.
Settlement.
I'm not happy.
Now, England at this time
I'm
is a hostile
not happy.
Place.
This is
so,
not what I wanted.
Succeed,
I have a smile on my face because I am so,
raiding,
I'm in complete
using
disbelief
their
longships right
and raiding
that guy literally said that I just see some new
fortifications
gameplay.
And epic battles.
What
they'll
gameplay? Is that gameplay? I can't tell. It's just a bunch of weird
Vikings,
cinematic camera
and
moments.
And they'll be faced with some very harsh choices as the leader of a community. Along with that, where we've reinvented combat.
I got my hopes up for an ass creep, and I got
shat on. Tons of enemy variety, dual-wielding weapons. We have a new, fresh take on player progression, gear, and weapon systems.
You know, I used to love Assassin's Creed. You know that? I was a huge fan. I was an only fan of Assassin's Creed, the very first one.
All this is just music to my ears.
And then it just
kind
of got weird, and then the second one was good, and then it got weird, and then the fourth one was amazing.
So,
amazingly good.
As a creative
I'm
director,
choking up over here. I'm like, and I can't even stand. This guy
game.
Fucking said
how
gameplay.
Of this new
oh,
number?
He said gameplay. I heard him. He said words gameplay. Did you see that gameplay?
Has always been committed to new technologies in order to push the most immersive experiences we possibly can. And so
I did think
that
jizzing. I thought
like
the alien sex was pretty good. I thought the Xbox sex alien edition was a pretty good looking game. But then Tulad said
Norway
the game was kickstarted back
England
in 2017.
Are breathtaking
now,
living world. So to be able to push them further to their incredible potential.
There's a logo here
really
that says Inside
for
Xbox.
It's wonderful for our players. And additionally, I'm very happy to confirm that we are also offering smart delivery, which allows you to purchase the game once and play it on your Xbox One and the Xbox Series X.
Hey,
that is great news, I think, for all the
that
Assassin's
is very
fans
good.
Out there,
hey, you know what? I'll give them up. I'm
going to
give that up, man. That's actually
that
really great. A smart purchase or whatever,
year.
A smart
thank
play.
You, so much, Ashraf,
you buy it on
us,
one console and it works on
the
next. You see, this is what I was really happy about this next generation.
Because
the PS4 and whatever the current Xbox is, that shit is just PCs, so there's no reason why you can't do this sort of a jump around thing, right? So the next generation, you could just buy it and you get both versions of the game. That's really great. That's really great. Of course, it would be cool if they were showing gameplay like they said they would, but you know what? Whatever. That's a cool thing. That's a cool feature. I like it. It's a real quality of life thing that makes really good sense. Let's not talk about the gameplay and how upset I am about all that.
So many great games today showcasing.
I hate you
for Xbox Series X.
I don't know your name.
Let's go to Malik right now.
I hate your headset. I hate your butt hash. I hate your jacket.
All right, everyone. Just
everything else is fine, but I hate all those things.
Dirt 5, and I kind of was
especially hate his gameplay. His gameplay is garbage.
We're gonna dive even deeper into everything. Right now, we have Robert Karp, who is Dirt 5's development director, in the driver's seat. To talk about what's next in the series, Robert, how are you?
I'm very well. How are
Let's
you
go really? Play some more COD.
I'm doing great. I'm doing great. Excited to dive into this. Now, Dirt 5, obviously the newest game in the series. Let's start with locations, because kind of the backdrop is kind of important for a racing game. So where are we going to be going in Dirt 5?
So you saw from the trailer, we had New York, then we went to China, and then we went to Norway. We've got lots more environments than that. Each
he
of the
said
environments
it was
are bespokely created based in real world. Attracting event
I don't really want to sit here and so watch all this stuff. Do you? You want to learn about dirt, fire, or whatever? The thing is like, I guess we should because these games are going to be on Steam, right? Everything we're seeing is going to be on Windows. So, fuck it. I mean, they're all options for me to play, man, if I want to play them. That Alien Sex game, like, can you guys dig up some more dirt on that? I want to know what that's about. Wow, the Arizona. Alien sex game. So I want to know a bit more. That actually, that I liked a lot of that was going on there. That was pretty cool. But I'm worried as fuck because it's a Kickstarter game. That can't be good.
As well as how the weather's going to change out.
Yeah, Dirt 5 had gameplay. Yeah, cars are racing. You're right. Yeah. But we were specifically told gameplay for Assassin's Creed Vanilla. We didn't get it. At least I didn't see it. I fucking saw cinematic bullshots.
In China. We also have sprint cars,
but you know,
really interesting. They go around.
I guess this is look. We're sitting here and we're shitting all over this stuff, right? Of course. But hold up. Sony hasn't done anything, right? We haven't even looked at Sony's console yet. We don't even know what it looks like. We know the controller, but we don't know what it looks like.
Oh, that's super cool.
So even though I'm giving all this more, shit right? on all this Xbox stuff,
that's pretty cool.
I think at this point in the console race, I think these guys are a little bit ahead.
What are some things that
especially with that whole buy it for one thing, get it for the other thing, I like that a lot.
You know, they're going to notice for the first time ever.
So you guys have literally been shitting on the games just as much, if not more, than I have. Except Turbo. Turbo is definitely sucking some Microsoft dick today. Did you get a recent Windows update? Is that why you're so favorable to Xbox these days? Maybe just the term Xbox sex is making you really happy. I've never known you to be this contrarian, Turbo Dog.
How quickly the time changes.
Have you tossed in your speedrunner's card? Are you no longer a Castlevania Symphony of the Night speedrunner, and now you're just a contrarian who jumps into my stream and talks anti-garbage?
That's super exciting. Split screen, something that we always
I can't believe you're trying to defend any of this. It's literally the same thing that we've always seen, like, every time. There's nothing here at all interesting, is there?
There's nothing. There's
just nothing interesting here. Roberti
has told me that there's a very dynamic
show nothing. There's nothing shown. Well, look, they at least showed the concept of these games. There was that one anime game that kind of might be interesting. I know Astral Chain did all right, right? People seem to enjoy that game. Maybe they're going to do another different kind of Astral Chain. All right, cool. Not really pushing the limits of the system, but at least there was that. Aliens have it. Troy Baker.
And there's really only one person to have as the protagonist to Troy Baker, who's the nemesis, and that's Baker Nolan North.
Thrilled to be working with
Nolan North. How are they voice actors in Dirt? I don't get it.
Also, you're gonna see some pretty recognizable.
I only
faces
hear
in this game, so
Uncharted right now.
It.
That's all I hear out of it. He's just only and ever only Uncharted.
You win the career.
Anime game and vampire.
Exciting,
anime game and vampire.
I'm excited to jump into the career,
and
two,
the alien sex.
I feel like a lot of
the aliens,
players,
those
are going to be happy about having both.
The Jet game really needed to show more. It would have been interesting. I don't know. I didn't really like that one. The weird flying spaceship thing was trash. Dirt is just another racing game, you know. Elden Ring gameplay coming with a U.
You'll be able to play it.
Showed art style. That's it. Yeah, that's the thing. Like, fucking. None of these look like they're going to really be any. But look, this is really common, right? This is very common for a release of a console. The first wave of games are always trash. You remember Killzone Shadowfall?
You can play on Xbox Series X as soon as you get a new console.
Remember Knack? That shit was terrible.
And you go over You have an Xbox One.
There's nothing to assess. I actually feel better saying that the Xbox is not going to be anything for me. There's no way I'm going to get an Xbox at this point. I really needed them to show something like great. I needed something great. You know, I'm gonna straight up tell you guys. I needed scale.
I love everything that you just said there. You buy the game, you get the best version for the platform that you own. You get in the game.
I'm not kidding.
Loading times are a thing that everyone.
If they had come up and had dropped scale bound right on my face.
4K 60 and 120 frames per second.
That could have done it.
So that
could have done it. I'm not even kidding. Scale bound.
Robert, thank you so much for stopping by. I gotta say that I probably speak for everyone.
Of course, it'd be for Windows, so I wouldn't have to buy Xbox anyways. But I at least would have been seeing their praises
on Xbox Series X.
No scale bound.
Coming up this year. Thank you so much for stopping by.
All right.
Thanks,
I'm interested. All right, we've already seen so many games so far, but the train's going to keep rolling, so we're going to throw it over to
the point of watching games you hate anyways?
To talk about
because that Kappa face makes shit fucking hilarious.
Horror games are a fan favorite, and the medium promises to keep us guessing and our hearts racing.
This is the hardline stance?
Here to tell us more about the game is
Shenmue,
Jack,
what is
game
that?
Producer
Five? From the Blue Four?
Thank you so much for joining us, Jack.
Shenmue is going to be on fucking PlayStation,
though. Can you tell us more about this game and the Blueberry Team
like
approach to the psychological horror genre?
I should be a coffin.
In our first psychological horror that was Layers of Fear,
it's Ninja?
It
who's Ninja? That guy?
Was,
he's a ninja? Or is it
can you sacrifice for your family? Can you sacrifice yourself? Or do you, need,
Air
or do you want to sacrifice yourself for your passion?
You know, I played
yourself.
Persona 5 Arena.
And the second,
or
4
Arena, Golden, or whatever.
And then the main topic was if I'm still human, if my mind
Goku.
Maybe is digitalized, or if I have robotic parts, where is the line? You know, like in the body horror stuff.
Why has this guy got the Incredible Hulk
in the
t-shirt on? Is he a, did he work on Avengers?
There was the forest that everyone loves.
This is like a total Eris game,
topic,
you know? This is like Eris is going to be like, oh,
PTSD.
It's a whole another horror
so
game,
and medium,
ah, spook, you know?
World in our game, real world and spirit world.
That's
we
a total
Eris
game.
That can see this both realities, so we can think like somebody can be a really good guy, but maybe inside it's not. And when you play as a medium, you have a really unique perspective to find out what is inside of other people and on all what
Man,
happens
that's...
in different places.
For the medium, we heard that you teamed up.
What happened
with
to the gameplay
legendary
of Assassin's Creed? I wanted actual.
Akira Yamaoka.
Show me
can
like a minute of just fighting some dudes.
That
that's what I
game?
Wanted. Just one
he's,
minute.
He's
of
the best now, of course,
just
for,
hitting some
for
people.
Composing
that's all I
music
wanted.
For Silent Hill series.
I just wanted to see what they were going to do.
And what was most important for us, it was his work on Silent Hill 2, because Silent Hill 2. For most of our team is the best horror game ever.
I'm sitting here waiting for the gameplay, and then the guy fucking pops into the screen and says, was that some new gameplay I just saw? And the other guy's like, yes. Literally sitting here, where's the gameplay? Where's the new gameplay? It's coming. The gameplay is coming. I know it's coming. And then the guy pops on screen, and I'm just flabbergasted. I've been fucking bamboozled. I've been bamboozled. Hoodwinked.
So it was really misdirected. And it was really great.
Please
fun.
Enjoy the
this
game.
This game is really characterized.
Be ashamed
by
of my words
worlds.
And deeds.
Can you talk to us more about the story and these two
it's
worlds
my fault.
And how the players can look
you
forward
to it? You
guys said
it at the
yeah,
start.
So you play as
and
Maria,
you've been saying it ever since.
And like she can
quote unquote
this, that she can, she goes,
getting excited
she
for an Assassin's Creed game,
world,
Kappa
second world, but. She's like
you guys said it.
Haunted by really one specific vision that she tried
fault.
To solve. And
I can't help
some kind of
it. I like the first Assassins.
The
I like the second one. I like the fourth one.
Vacation resort.
There's a couple
like
other good ones I thought were
hotel.
All right.
Man. So she go there and then she need to, you know, find out how the vision is connected with this place and what
it physically
that
hurts.
Mystery is there.
Physically,
and there two words
like it's
came
physical.
Up because our
I am in
world,
real discomfort.
And our real
I feel
like
discomfort
Poland,
watching
late
this
80s,
right now. You realize
Krakow,
that this is
Krakow
pain and suffering
for
me.
For
I don't
history.
Like this. I want to go back to playing Call
and
of Duty.
Of
level
here,
up with my new
city.
Military sim that I got.
And you know, it's a free Poland.
I was mildly interested,
but
then they mentioned that they are
the
devs behind Observer,
regime,
and now I've deflated completely.
Regime, and there was
never
like
heard
no
of Observer.
Free of speech, there was
but this
sensor,
is totally not a thing
and
I'd
when
be
you play
interested
as a
in.
Medium,
this is, like I said, this is an Eris game. This is not a game for me.
Opportunity to see even
world
further than normal people because
smile.
You see the spirit world. And spirit world is like.
Why has he got a fucking Incredible Hulk shirt on, though?
Like when all your anger, urges, secrets.
It's like the most interesting thing right now is his fucking shirt.
It's also hostile world in some way. So only medium can, like, you know, solve some puzzles, some mysteries, and survive that kind of encounter.
All these games. Oh God, he's really the Blair Witch dev. That's fucking crazy. I'm not
can
him,
really
but the
take advantage of
the group that did
some
it.
Very immersive
That's
gameplay.
Wild. That's
Where are some
wild.
Of the Xbox
that was
Series
a horrible
X
game.
Features that Aris
played that
has
like twice and flushed it.
To make sure that you can deliver
walking
this
art
epic
piece, right?
And
that's exactly what it is.
Medium.
It's gotta
yeah,
be. That
of
way.
Course. First
I hope
of
they show
all,
the new Tekken character.
Xbox
exclusive Tekken character.
So
it's just a giant dong.
Stuff
Xbox sex.
For
it's just a giant
game.
Dong in
awesome
Tekken.
Because we spent a lot of years to thinking about this game, how we can fulfill our dreams about it, but we have a problem with the platform. Like, everything we thought is too weak to fulfill.
Internet, this is not
our
what
vision.
I wanted to
but
do.
Then,
but you know what? I had a bad feeling
and
the moment we started doing this, and yet I have to do my
and
streamer obligation, right? I gotta watch this shit
for
with
us
you guys. This is a streamer obligation. You can't ignore this part.
It.
If you're going to be a streamer,
and,
like you got to sit here and fucking watch all the dribble that comes
like,
out
know,
of the gaming industry.
The FPS and no loading screens.
But at least
because
we can talk
know,
shit about
like
it, right? I mean,
horror,
fucking
cinematic
boo,
experience.
Bad games.
And you have two worlds.
Your shirt
you
is stupid, boo.
Them. You can travel between them, you can travel between the levels, and the whole
there is no actual gameplay footage shown. Boo.
It's like awesome. And
it's
of course
the most
we
chat you've had
Xbox
in weeks. Series
X in different
how many
ways,
numbers am I up on the viewership?
In different ways,
should
but
I put a big red letter that says how many viewers
future,
I have
so
right now in chat?
Ooh, mysterious.
A big seven? Ooh, lucky 7777.
I think
seven,
I speak
seven,
for
seven,
all the fans
seven.
When I say that I'm super excited.
I won $30
on
a lucky
on the Xbox
scratch and sniff for
thank
lucky
you so much
sevens
for joining
recently.
Us today, Jack.
So I was really hype about that. But now the lucky sevens is all drained out.
Special
so
thank
I gotta,
you to
I
all of
play
our developers from around the world who pulled out all the stops to share this first look at Xbox Series X gameplay.
Hey, he's got a fridge in the background.
Today.
Look,
it's
got
also
a fridge
great
in the background.
To see how many developers are taking advantage
that's
and leveraging things like smart delivery, really putting our fans first. And of course, we're doing that with all of
I think
our
they're
Xbox
trying to show that they're
titles.
Self-aware,
said,
that their console looks like a giant
off.
Fridge. You know, at this point, I would have been more excited if they actually showed some Halo.
It's Xbox Game Studios world premieres revealed
honestly if they had showed some new Halo I think I would have been more excited for that than everything else they did so far. Are they done or are they oh my god it said stick around for more Assassin's Creed. Oh, I guess they already did it. It was that guy talking about what we literally just saw. That was it, man. I don't know what I was expecting, you know. I gave these guys credit earlier, right? I gave these guys credit earlier because I said that at least they showed something, right? But if I'm being real with you, I think it would have been better not showing anything at all. It's just Vampire the Masquerade. Look, the faces on that looked off. I kind of want to go back and look at that trailer again because it looked really bad. I don't want to see it again. Ugh, fuck it. Honestly, like, I don't think showing gameplay, and they didn't even show any gameplay, did they? They showed like a little bit for like two or three games, I think. And honestly, they didn't even really do that, did they? I was tired. I wanted to give these guys props. At least they're showing stuff, right? Like, hey, check out this game, and blah, 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 you know? But there wasn't hardly any gameplay, actual gameplay of these games. It was just a giant showcase of trailers. That was really upsetting. I love how chat's blowing up right now. what's this? Ubisoft made like 5 million games and at this point still doesn't know what gameplay is. Yeah, seriously, I love that the guy literally came on the screen and said, is that new gameplay I just looked at? And the other guy's like, sure enough. And we're literally here just like, where's the gameplay? Where are the games? Where are the video games at? You know? Like, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air? Where the video... Oh, God. That was not expected. I didn't expect that. Hold up.
What happened in here?
We was robbed!
Oh my God! What'd they take?
This is my reaction.
Oh, I knew it.
Second of all, Uncle Phil, give him a job, Uncle Phil. There's probably a perfectly good explanation for all of this. Like what? Ben?
Oh, shut up! Any idiot can see he's guilty. I'm calling the...
Wait a minute. Come on, let's just calm down here. I mean, come on. I mean, what did we lose for real? A bunch of things.
This is how I feel.
We're all healthy. Huh?
This is how I feel.
We're all safe. Huh? Where the video games? Where the video? Oh! Ah, huh. All right, I can't breathe.
That entire segment, I was just like, where's the gameplay? Where are the video games? Where's the gameplay? Couldn't have been less happy. They said it would be gameplay. They didn't say gameplay and then put spaces between each letter. They didn't say gameplay in quotation marks. They didn't say gameplay with like alternating capital letters. They didn't do gameplay in like a weird font or upsize, downsize, scaled weird. No. They just said gameplay. Where the gameplay at? Where the video games at? Where the video games? This is how I feel. Where are they? You're really entitled. Oh. I can't stop thinking about it. When the guy came out, is that some new gameplay I just saw? Yes, sir. I'm still like, where's the gameplay? Man, that was fucking... That was good. That was really good. You can't script that shit, man. That is hilarious. He said, is that new gameplay I just saw? Oh. That's tickling me really good. That's going to be inside me for a long time. I really like that. That was super good. Isn't it Phil Spencer that works on Xbox or some shit? Somebody get that guy on the horn. Oh, my cheeks are hurting. I'm smiling too much. I really liked shitting on all that, but at the same time, that was really hard to sit through. Now, honestly, I'm being real with you. That was hard to sit through. That was just complete marketing stuff, right? It was E3, like, ranked up to 11 and all that shit. But why... Man, I really want to play some Call of Duty right now. Here's the thing, though. I was going to play some Oblivion, right? So now I don't know what I'm going to do. Fuck me. I don't know what I'm going to do. That's going to be fucked up. It's better than E3. Well, I guess there was like one or two moments of gameplay, so... I guess. Can you guys... What's for realsies? Enough joking around. Enough beating around the bush. Was there actually a game in there that was anywhere near interesting to any of you? Vampire the Masquerade, I'm almost interested in only because I know it's an old game that, and this is like a brand new thing for it. Yakuza, I kind of... Okay, maybe. The thing is that it's not the main guy, right? It's not the main dude. It's this weird other dude. And it looked really zany and over the top and shit. And like, that could be cool. That might be more interesting than how Yakuza's been. Because Yakuza is just so fucking... So many words and shit, right? But at least the main character is cool. The main dude is fucking whack. Yeah, this main dude looks pretty fucking whack, right? I don't really get what's going on with that. But, I mean, it's still... At least it's still Yakuza. Oh my god, that's fucking great. That is so great. Exactly. It's exactly how I feel. This is the gameplay. Man. This is how I felt with everything there. What can you do? It's how it be do, right? There's nothing to be done. It's fucking... I almost feel like they would have been better if they had not done anything. Now, my main dude? Fucking, what is his name anyways? I wanted him in Tekken like a bunch. What was his name? I can't remember. Fuck it. Who cares? Put RoboCop in Tekken. Yeah, right? Put Instinct Goku in Tekken. Put Instinct, Ultimate Instinct in Goku in Tekken. That's right, Kazama. Fucking something Kazama. I can't remember the whole thing. He would have been cool, right? He would have been cool. I just can't seem to recall any. But the fucking... And you know, here's the thing, right? Like, I... The only cool thing I can really take away that I honestly think is cool. Being able to buy the game for a PS... For an Xbox, whatever, and then having access to the Xbox Sex version. I think that's good. I think that's really good. The reason I think that is because... I want the PlayStation 4 to do it. My mind is so fucked up right now. Like, it's like I'm so fucking thrown off by the lack of gameplay. The gameplay... I want to play Assassin's Creed Vanilla, right? I want to play it. But I'm probably... If the game comes out before the PS5, I'm probably going to play it on the PS4. And then the PS5 will come out. I wanted to play it on the PS5. So, if I were to buy it on a PlayStation, on a PlayStation 4, I, at least right now, would not get access to that PlayStation 5 version. If I bought an Xbox... I could. That is a cool feature. It's a cool feature no matter how you splice it. It's a cool feature. Get Xbox. Smile. But that's it. It's a cool feature and that's it. And then is it going to be any good? It's not going to be any good to you once you actually have the Xbox Sex, right? Like, you're not going to buy games on your Xbox not Sex. You're going to buy the Xbox Sex games from there on out. So it's only cool for this intermediary moment between console shifting. But it's still cool, you know? If Sony had that kind of thing, that would be fucking fantastic. But I don't think they would do that. I mean, right? I don't think they would do that. That does not seem like something Sony would do. I gotta be honest, though. I'm really disappointed about how graphically everything looked. It honestly looked like nothing really changed or improved. And I was really hoping for more something. You know, more stability, more experience, more visual. I was hoping for more because we're on new systems now. You know, we got upgraded systems. But... it really looked like all the same shit. And the thing is a lot of those games are multi-plat, and a lot of them are just normal games, right? They're just multi-plat games that are being made right now, and they're not being made for the next consoles, right? So, maybe that's the problem, you know? Graphics will peak, yeah, definitely. Chinese are too cheap to not get your games American-made. Yeah, maybe, who knows? But fucking, yeah, I was really looking forward to, like, a bit of a boost, you know, performance-wise or something, anything, but it didn't look like anything changed. That dinosaur game where they were shooting dinosaurs, that kind of seemed sort of cool, but I mean, you know, it's just because it's dinosaurs. Neck looks better than Final Fantasy VII Re? Man, you are just... You're definitely leaving some shits right now, aren't you? You guys are so turnt, man. Every time this kind of a weird stream goes down, everybody gets fucking turnt. I need a fucking stiff drink. And I think we should go back to COD because my brother is not awake yet. Oh, man. But I said I'd play some Oblivion, didn't I? It's not really looks that I mean to point at. But at the same time, it kind of is. Because I just don't think 60 FPS... Yeah, right? So I just don't think gameplay or 60 FPS... I don't think that performance is ever going to get better. I think it's all about making things run... like, where they want it. Like, asking for 60 FPS is out of the question. I will be ecstatic if we even get consistent 30 FPS on anything. But that's what I'm hoping for. I didn't see it in a lot of those trailers, though. I honestly didn't see it. It did not look smooth. I don't think any of those games looked smooth to me. Yeah, walking sims all day. But whatever. I mean, it's fucking Xbox. I didn't come in thinking it was going to be anything. I thought it was actually going to be gameplay. But... egg on my face. There was like two bits of gameplay. And it was very small and not much of anything. But you know, now that I think about it, didn't they specifically say, I'm getting excited about games playing on the Xbox X? Remember that? I think they were saying, oh no, these aren't gameplay. These are games being played on the Xbox X. And they were trailers being played on the Xbox X. Fucking got me again. Remember the Baldur's Gate 3 gameplay? Oh no. The one time I wish they didn't show me the gameplay. Take this gameplay back. It's not done. It's already been done. You just reskin fucking Divinity. It's the cutscene in the game. It's the gameplay. It's being played in the game. Even though it's a cutscene, it is gameplay. Man. Right now, I feel like they're playing a game and I'm losing. And I don't even know the rules.